Will PRP recover hair in my temples and hairline area? I've lost plenty of hair in my temples and hairline area. I'm undergoing PRP therapy that involves 10 sessions, 1 week apart. I have undergone 3 sessions so far. Will PRP help me to regain my lost hair, temples, and hairline? I'm attaching my pictures of the area in question. Most of my hair loss took place in the last year. I've been using minoxidil 5% for the last 2.5 years. Thank you. Looking forward to your answers.
Thank you for your question. You've submitted 2 photos, and you're asking, will PRP recover your hair loss in your temples? And you stated that you've been losing hair and you've been using minoxidil for about 2.5 years. And currently, you are on the, you've completed 3 sessions of what will be a 10 weekly session process of getting PRP injections. So naturally, I think it's understandable that you want to know, will this actually work? Well, I can certainly give you my perspective, a little bit of background. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. I'm also the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers. This is a technology we developed in our practice while doing hair transplants, which uses PRP as well as acellular matrix, which I'll discuss further, and as a non-surgical treatment that has been significant and has changed the way we practice in helping people with hair loss. So I'll share with you my experience with PRP as it relates to hair loss. Now, to begin with, PRP, or platelet-rich plasma, is a concentration of wound-healing growth factors that are naturally in your blood. And they stimulate collagen, they stimulate blood supply. They have a lot of different factors that, when concentrated, have shown to have a stimulatory effect for hair follicles. Now, that being said, and these have been actually documented in dermatologic literature to help certainly validate the use of PRP. In our practice, we use PRP a lot. We use it for skin rejuvenation, we use it for wrinkles, we use it for under-eye dark circles, we use it for acne scars. We use PRP a lot. But when it comes to hair loss, experience that we've had is that PRP will stimulate hair growth, but it will not stop the progression of hair loss. It will not, and it's a very important element to your plan, because when you, in my experience, people have come to us getting PRP done elsewhere. They've done it like once a month, and by the 4th month, they were not sure whether or not they were going anywhere. There have been others who recommend doing it every 3 months. And I think that a lot of my colleagues are developing their own approach based on their clinical experience. And I think why it varies, it has to do a lot with the stage of the growth cycle and whether or not the resting stage or telogen stage of hair is actually being responsive to the injection. So from my perspective, weekly PRP injections seem fairly aggressive. Physiologically speaking, just on the wound healing concept and the actual physiology of wound healing, it seems like you're creating new wounds by just entering the tissue space or the skin, and you might be disrupting what's going on. Now, that in no way means that your doctor doesn't have a valid explanation of why they're recommending weekly treatments. You know, one thing about clinical medicine that should always be respected is that each individual physician is making a decision to guide you on what's best for you based on their experience. This is the art of clinical medicine. Now, that being said, I'm going to introduce you to a little bit about what we developed in our practice, which is relevant because we use PRP. We were first trying to help hair transplant patients heal better. So we were using PRP. We were then using PRP with something called acellular matrix. This is a wound healing technology that takes the regenerative capacity of PRP to a very different level. It is not like getting very high concentrated PRP, which is a lot of people are trying to improve the concentration of platelets, but rather there's a certain behavior that is unique to extracellular matrix. And what it does is it heals by duplication of cells. So when placed on muscle cells, it heals with muscle instead of scar tissue. On skin, when I use it for facelifts or any other cosmetic surgical procedure, I find that the healing is accelerated and the appearance is remarkable. Now, what we ultimately developed was a protocol based on an observation. And the observation was that thinning hair started to look thicker in different patients when we were combining platelet-rich plasma with acellular matrix for the purpose of healing the donor area of the hair transplant patient as well as the hair grafts themselves. Long story short, we developed a protocol, and that now has been successfully consistent for 99% of men and women with genetic pattern hair loss and or genetic alopecia. With hair regeneration, we're able to stop progression, reactivate hair that is not growing, which is basically in the resting phase, which is prolonged when hair is thinning, as well as induce the shed of thinning hair and the regrowth and the growth of thicker hair. Again, with many years of data, in fact, with over 5 years of data, we've not seen any significant trend of regression. So to contrast hair regeneration with what you're going through, it really is no comparison. We do a single injection and we're able to get consistently 5 years of successful improvement of hair loss. We've developed it even further, so for people with more severe, moderate to severe hair loss, we do something called a booster injection, which is around 15 months later. So it's really a very different model, even though we are using PRP. So I think you need to certainly ask your doctor, and I'm sure your doctor probably said to you that they're going to do their best and see if you get any growth. And it depends a lot on the salvageability of the hair follicles. Again, for me, a weekly injection of PRP doesn't seem to make sense for when you think of the physiology of wound healing. But your doctor may have a protocol, and I'm sure you looked at before and after pictures and other things. But the question really ultimately is, how long can you really keep doing this? You know, going for injections in the scalp once a week for 10 weeks may be fine, but how long can you do that? Do you have to keep doing that again for another 10 weeks? In my observation has been that PRP can stimulate hair growth, but it cannot stimulate sustained hair growth. So I think this is an opportunity for you to learn more about the technology behind hair regeneration and our experience, and you can then at least compare and contrast your options and certainly discuss the feasibility and when should you expect results. You know, when we talk to our patients about hair regeneration, we have treated so many people from around the world and we have so much data that we collect and we follow our patients every 3 months that we're able to give them very specific information about the scenarios and how they can play out, and then we follow up each patient and take very specific photos, microscope photos, etc., to be able to document their improvement. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.